During the 17th century, over a quarter of a million paintings were created by Dutch artists. Look at these paintings. A lot of them were still life, vanitas paintings. And apart from the obvious flowers, they had one thing in common. Can you guess what it is? It kept recurring in most of these paintings. This tiny fruit with its bright color and nubby rind became a symbol of wealth, abundance, and exotic commodities. A lemon that was whole, halved, or with that perfect peel just hanging off the edge of the table. It was not the prettiest fruit or even the sweetest. What accounted for the sudden rise of lemon peel in these paintings? The lemon, citrus limon, are thought to have originated in northwestern India near the foothills of the Himalayas and first appeared in Italy during the Middle Ages around 1000 AD. It was first cultivated in Liguria and then in the south of Italy and Sicily and later spread by the Arabs into Andalusia, current-day Spain, in the 13th century. Two decades later, when the lemons were cultivated in Lake Garda in northern Italy, they could be exported in large quantities to the north. This coincides with Dutch independence from Spain, with direct access to trade with the Mediterranean. These paintings reflected a thriving global economy with increased trade that later on became a foundation for the Industrial Revolution and development of modern economy. The volume of trade doubled in Europe in between the 1600s and 1650s and doubled again by 1700. This makes sense because at that time, Europeans were taking over the world and the Dutch were at its forefront in trade due to its shipping industry. It was Peter Klaas who used the lemon peel for the first time in still life paintings. It was the year 1621 and this is where the trend began. A 2016 study statistically analyzed artworks from the 1500 to 2000 to interpret the role of food in paintings. Researchers found that foods depicted in paintings were related to people's identities and viewpoints rather than what they actually ate. Lemons in particular had the largest depiction in paintings across all art periods. During this research, it was calculated that the lemon appeared in 51% of the Dutch paintings during the middle of the 17th century. Lemons made their way into medical treatises, Dutch recipes, and evoked mythological notions of the intrinsic nature of relationships, the religious views on materialism, and the Dutch families. In 1668, The Pleasurable Country Life, a manuscript that provided advice for merchant class owners of country homes, included a section entitled The Sensible Cook that contained 189 recipes. Out of these, 29 included lemons in preparations of various kinds. It started becoming a regular food at the table of everyday people and not just the elite. The lemons in Dutch paintings also recalled popular medical advice. For example, as seen in this Van de Velde's painting, it reflects the advice of Christopherus Versen, a 16th century physician. In the sections labeled on poisons, Versen mentions that the juice and the syrup of citrons and everything that is made from it amongst the list of things that counteract poison. Part of the lemon's appeal was also in its diverse set of uses. In medicine, it was used as a cure of nausea and seasickness. They found that its juice prevented scurvy, a disease that had ravaged crews on long sea voyages. The artists might also be using more lemons to bring a touch of vibrancy in their paintings in the cool light of the north. The rich yellow color of the fruit with its beautiful light reflective centers glowed through these still life paintings. It also showed the talent of the artist through these paintings because it was quite difficult to make a peel stand out in a painting and to make it look three-dimensional rather than just 2D and flat. The other challenge was to artfully create this peel without breaking and having it positioned just so at the edge of the table. And I can attest to that when I created one of my own.
Isn't it beautiful?
A I want to enhance the highlights on the lemon a tiny bit. So I'm going to squeeze some of the juice from the lemon itself and apply it to the highlights. Another hack that you can use is just apply some oil or water. Oil actually might work better because it'll give that beautiful highlights on the lemon. It showed the mastery that this artist had on their craft. The lemons were interpreted as celebratory or cautionary portrayals of wealth and exotic abundance. The lemons at the edge of the painting also offered viewers a highly visible culture of the citrus that gives expression to the peak of Dutch prosperity. In paintings, this Mediterranean commodity showed how powerful these forces were to the daily life of the Dutch. The illusionistic quality of the lemon connects painterly practice to symbolic, emblematic, mythological, religious, and real-life meanings that appeal to the viewer and the artists. These painters never set out to paint the economy, but the repeated use of lemon peel in so many paintings was a symbol of varied interests in the Dutch society at that particular time. So next time you pick up a lemon for a delicious lemonade or a million other recipes that you use it for, well, at least I do, you know how much impact this one small fruit had over the economics of an entire country.